Hey everyone, Slightly here. This is going to be an in-game demo of all the features that come with Carbon Copy, brought to you in collaboration by Dreadwrith and I. Now, if you haven't looked at it already, be sure to check out our product trailer video. And if you need help setting it on your avatars, we're going to have a series of Unity tutorials that go over how to set it up as quickly as possible, as well as all the little intricate details and all the customizability that we have to offer in the tool. If you have further questions beyond any of that, or beyond this video, be sure to check out our official documentation on GitHub, as well as check out the Discord server for support channels and to ask any additional questions you may have. Without further ado, let's go ahead and dive right in. Be sure to look at and follow along with the menu over here on the side, and let's go ahead and just jump into the submenu for Carbon Copy. We have four options here, and essentially Carbon Copy is broken down into three sort of suites of features. Now, anything in orange is going to be a submenu. Anything in yellow is going to be a toggle. And we have Mimic, Mirror, and Quick. Let's go ahead and start with Quick for a second. Now, Quick is what we're going to start with because Quick also exists as a shortcut in Mimic and Mirror, and it works together with both of those. So here in Quick, we're going to start with Invis, which will go ahead and take your own self and instantly just turn you invisible, right? You can make yourself reappear whenever you want. Swap will replace you with a copy of your clone on top of yourself, so that when I walk over, I'm actually invisible over here, you can't see me, and turning off swap will make me appear again, all right? Now, if I use anchor, it'll drop an invisible clone position right here, so that when I do activate swap, instead of dropping on myself, it'll go ahead and drop wherever I drop my anchor. So that way I can swap and unswap back and forth, and it'll sort of look like I'm teleporting. This also works in conjunction with Mimic and etc. So if I go ahead and get rid of the anchor real quick, I'm gonna skip a few of these settings for right now until we go to Mimic, but up here for freeze, I can go ahead and drop a frozen copy of myself whenever I want. And that'll be the frozen clone. So let's go ahead and dive right into the Mimic module. And in here, we have your generic little Mimic clone, right? Where if I go ahead and drop a Mimic clone of myself right here, it'll stay in place no matter where I go and sort of copy all my movements, right? But we have a unique feature here called Confirm. And by moving away from my clone and using it, I can confirm or lock this offset so that when I walk, they'll maintain that distance from me. Now, unconfirming doesn't get rid of the clone or the position or reset it. I can now continue to change my offset and then reconfirm. Just like that. Unconfirm, reconfirm, and you get the idea. That's confirm. Now, in our quick menu, we have an option down here called bind, and that'll let me go ahead and take the clone and bind it to any sort of part of my body as I want. Here's my right hand. Right, here's my left hand. I can do my feet, hips, chest, head, etc. And we have an extra one down here, which by default means you can go ahead and use the clone like a spring joint ball, right? Between your hands, so it can be my other hand as well, or just orbiting. Anyway, so that'll go ahead and be bind. Now, we have a feature here called lag, where notice how the movement of the clone is very flowy right now in normal speed. Lag, you can go ahead and intentionally make the clone stutter and jitter and lag, which is sort of like a meme, little fun feature than anything. I don't really have any practical purpose of this. This speed is configurable in the tool as well. By default, I believe it's 5 FPS. Woo! I'm gonna turn that off. And then lastly, we have hide. And that'll go ahead and hide the clone wherever it is, but it won't disable the clone. That way, when I re-enable hide, it'll show it again. And this has more advanced applications in some of the mirroring techniques, and you'll figure out uses for it if you really want to. I'm gonna go ahead and close out of this little quick menu. And lastly, we have the scale module, which works with Mimic or Mirror. But in the scale module, we have something called scale size, and that'll let me go ahead and change the scale of the clone, either big or small, right? I'm gonna reactivate it right here for you can see a little better. If I go ahead and bring him down all the way small, right? all the way down here. He's still in place. Everything is meant to work together as best as possible. So that means while scaled down, I can still confirm if I want to. And if I go ahead and confirm, now the clone will go ahead and follow my space. But you'll notice he's not moving according to his own size, but following my movement. So in the scale menu, we have something called proportional movement. And in proportional movement, I can change whether or not the clone moves according to his size or my size. So on the XZ plane, for example, by turning on proportional movement, now the clone will move according to his own size, which lets me effectively walk past him and walk around him as much as I want, right? And in the vertical Y axis, if I go ahead and jump, he's going to his height, and then by turning that off, he now moves up with my height. And that'll be proportional movement, essentially. I'm gonna unconfirm real quick. And now with scale, I can go ahead and use scale toggle, and that'll just quickly toggle between scaled and unscaled, so I can go back to full size on a whim if I want to, right? And that'll be that. Now, scale is sort of fun when you do some sort of small size and combine it with other features such as bind. So if I go ahead and now bind the little mini me, right? I can actually go ahead and pick him up and hold him by my hand. Right. From that point on, you can also go ahead and freeze him. And there's just a lot of applications in terms of everything really working together. Let me go ahead and unfreeze. Right. Let me go ahead and unbind. Just like that. So let me turn him off. Let me go ahead and reset that scale. So now lastly, the last module we have is mirror. So in the mirror module, we essentially have three different kinds of mirror clones, one of which is going to be called mirror standard. And with mirror standard, I can go ahead and drop it on myself and it'll copy all my movements along this sort of one plane so that it is essentially a mirror copy of myself. The avatar itself is also flipped, so if there were text, they would have it backwards, etc. That's mirror standard. Mirror radial is going to be from a single point on the ground. It'll go ahead and move with radial symmetry around that point. So if I go ahead and drop it on myself, I can go ahead and walk around like that. That's radial symmetry, or radial mirror. And with vertical mirror, if I go ahead and show you, upon activation, it'll go ahead and spawn a mirror clone of myself vertically underneath me, right? So with that said, if I go ahead and also play space down, I can also put a copy of myself on the ceiling, etc. Right? From here, you can freeze and do a bunch of other cool little handstands or tricks. And that is going to be the vertical mirror, right? Now, from there, everything again from quick and scale should work with all of those as well, as best as we can. And lastly, we have a settings module down here for a few additional settings, right? Two of these over here are on the left hand side are a little niche, but we have freeze behavior, which has to do with the way dynamic bones on frozen clones work. If you're more interested in what that does, just check it out in our documentation. As well as under settings, dyne invert. When you're doing a vertical clone, you don't really see it on this model, but a vertical clone, after it flips, if you had force or gravity on your dynamic bones, they would go upwards. Using dyne invert will make it fall down with real world gravity instead. You get to pick how it behaves. Lastly, under settings, if you haven't noticed it already, we have had icons sort of appearing on the screen-ish. On your HMD, on your headset, you're gonna see on your HUD essentially menu indicators for all of these features. That way you don't have to look at your menu to know what's toggling on or off. And this essentially lets us save a lot of memory on the system by boiling it down from 30 to 40 down to like less than 20, right? If you don't like the HUD, you can turn it off. That's what that setting's for. All right. The last two settings are going to be probably some of the hardest in the entire system, really for those advanced users or performers that really want to optimize their performance. And that's going to be, for example, gesture control. So gesture control is going to take the entire core of Carbon Copy and boil it down to purely gesture based. So you'll notice my menu is not even open over here on the side. But with gesture control, I can still on the fly mimic, confirm, unconfirm, walk away, confirm, unconfirm, etc. Whenever I want, I can make myself invis, reappear. I can swap positions and actually appear over here, right? I can go ahead and freeze. All the mirror modes, right? So mirror standard, right? Mirror radial, as well as mirror vertical, which you can't really see because I'm on look at me cam. But there you go, right? All of those were activated purely through gestures, which is really difficult unless you're very good at gesture locking. So I can go ahead and do one of these, activate gesture lock off my controller, and that way I don't have to mess with my fingers, right? But let's say you don't really have a gesture lock button on your controller, or you just don't want to hold these at all times. You can use our alternative gesture control called Jutsu Control. Now, this is for the weebs out there, but essentially, Jutsu Control works similarly to gesture control in the sense that all the gesture controls are the same and all the features are the same between the two control modes. But Jutsu Control starts with a trigger gesture of some sort. Yes, I made it this, where you can do it, and then whatever gesture control you do, it'll hold for you, regardless of what I do my fingers. That way I can do my trigger gesture again, confirm whenever I want, and I don't have to worry about holding it the whole time. And this lets you layer more and more during your performance. And then whenever you need to get rid of it all, you can go ahead and do a reset gesture of a sort. So the benefit of it is you can layer more on top of each other and you don't have to hold it. The downside is it takes a little bit longer to activate due to the nature of the trigger gestures, etc. Personally, I'm a gesture control guy. It's really up to you, whatever you get used to, but you have multiple options for that. So with that, I think that is our entire menu. If you want to know more about what you can do with it, we have things we haven't even talked about more on the documentation and especially the tool side. For example, suffixing, multi-clones, all right? If you want to have more than one clone, two clones, three clones, just use a really good performance avatar, all right? Watch out. But we have more to offer on that side, so be sure to check those videos out. If you have any questions, reach out to us on Discord, read our documentation. Bye.